Thanks for watching Film Buff, really, honestly. It's fucking great. Alright.
Hello guys, how's it going? My name is Im, Film Buff. Alright guys, so it's time for a new show. So I've known about this show for a long, long time. Just never really had the chance to, you know, jump in and check it out because there's so many other shows going on. You know, I know it's on the History Channel. At first that kind of set me for a loop. I'm like, huh, History Channel. Now apparently it is based loosely, or I'm not sure if it's loosely or like super accurate, on real history, like historic characters. I don't know any of it, you know, I know none of it, so to me, anything is a spoiler. You know, if you tell me anything, it's a spoiler at this point, because I don't know the history. If indeed these are based on, you know, accurate real-life characters, or not characters, people that existed. I know a lot of my friends have been asking me to check it out. A lot of you guys have been asking me to check this out, so yeah, man, I'm down, you know. And I believe season 4 is airing at the moment, so you know, I've got 4 seasons to catch up to, and I honestly think I might be able to do one episode a day. At first, I'm gonna put this first episode out, you know, and see how things go. I'm obviously gonna still do the whole show. I just want to see how things go. Once the first episode's out, you know, then I'm gonna get into a routine and just, you know, one episode every day. I'm gonna, you know, check out one episode, but I'm gonna try my best to, you know, upload an episode a day or a new episode every 2 days, you know, something like that. I think I should be able to do that. I think that's all I need to say, man. Let's just get right into the show. Oh, okay. I think I have my thumbnail. Get him! The fuck was that, man? That shit was creepy.
He's not old enough.
He's 12 years old.
Take him next year. Next year, soon enough.
It's really similar to Game of Thrones at the beginning.
Need a silver ribbon like Agatha.
Bran needs to see this. He's too young.
You're a handsome boy. Funny ears, though. Odin gave his eye to acquire knowledge. But I would give far more.
Ooh, I like it.
And will Earl Haroldson let you?
Go on.
The fuck? Who are these creepers?
We know you're all alone here.
Oh, she's gonna fuck them up, isn't she?
I don't want to kill you, woman.
You couldn't kill me if you tried for 100 years.
She's a badass. Nicely done. She's a badass, her husband's a badass.
Bjorn.
Bjorn. Bjorn.
So here you are, brother.
Rollo?
Freya and all the gods, how you've grown.
Hello, Rollo.
Are you here for the thing? You're a real man now. Come. Let's get a drink.
Rollo. What a name.
I have something that will change everything.
What?
Keep the noon shadow on the circle, and your course will be true. West.
Westeros. I'm just joking. Oh.
You see? There's a sun. Now we go west.
All right. Ragnar's got it all figured out, man. Oh, this guy. I've seen him in... Oh, shit. He's from The Usual Suspects, man. Pretty sure that's him. Can't remember his name.
How do you wish to die?
By beheading, Lord.
Dude, trial by combat.
Your wish is granted. You should be executed tomorrow.
Ah, bro, really?
Feed him to your pigs.
And I curse him. May he never enter Valhalla. May he never feast with the gods.
Well, that's not cool, bro.
Why did he do that?
He should not have done. Someone told me he wanted that lamb for himself. He knew Tryggveson had the best claim to it, but refused to sell it.
Mmm.
You hear that, boy? This is how things are done around here.
I kind of feel like I'm the boy, like I'm his son, and I'm learning all these things right now.
Bjorn.
Yes, Lord.
And do you freely give your fealty to me, your lord, your chieftain?
I don't like this guy, man.
Yes, Lord.
I can't be sure. But I believe it.
I don't care what you believe. You insulted me out there. And not for the first time.
Oh, shit.
But believe me, it will be the last.
Who told you you could go?
Look at this little rat.
And don't ever stick your nose in my face again.
Oh, he will, man. I hate this guy and his rat sidekick. Already. I mean, it's been like one episode. Wow. That's gorgeous, man.
Where are they? Where are my sons? You said you'd found them.
It's a dream?
We have someone special to visit. His name is Floki.
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 Like Loki, the god?
Yes. Only different.
How is he different?
He's not a god.
I know what those blacksmiths are like. Those greedy bastards.
For the anchor. It's all I have left from last summer's raids. Don't worry.
Damn, he's really banking
we'll
on this idea,
be
man.
As rich as dwarves.
Where are your parents?
They're having sex.
Okay.
Well, many will be afraid. Some may even go to him and betray us.
I must go, Piss.
I'm getting some bad feelings here from Rollo, man. Something seems off. Don't do it, Rollo.
Shouted out in pleasure. Didn't see her face.
Saw yours.
Saw yours. I think about you all the time.
Oh, well.
That's too bad.
insult me, Shield Maiden?
No. I would never insult you. You're too great a warrior. But perhaps not so great a man.
Odin. Bro, it's a three-eyed raven, man. Dude, that's so creepy. I feel like he's gonna do something fucked up. Like sabotage or something. Goddamn rat. Ah, this asshole had to find out. All right. There it is, man. Episode one. I liked it. You know, I enjoyed that first episode. A few really cool characters so far. Yeah, you know what, man? Before I even go any further, let me try to just say their names of the ones I remember. You know, so I kind of want to just start to get the names. So main homeboy Ragnar, his son Bjorn. His brother Rollo. Super cool name, Rollo. Doesn't quite fit, but okay. Oh man, who's that? The little magician dude. Not magician, but like the guy who, you know, the boat. Floki. What was his wife's name? Gita, right? I think so. Greta or Gita. Okay, so that's four of them. Who else is there? The Earl. It's been one episode and I can't stand this guy, the Earl. Dickhead. The Ancient One. Who else is there? And then, other than that, the two other main type characters that I could think of, well, not main characters, but like ones that are going to have an impact on the story going forward, were the two ratty fuckers, like his henchmen, the Earl's henchmen, the one, you know, little chubby dude, you know, beard, can't remember his name, and then the guy with the scar, his right-hand man, or just like this guy, this guy who works for him. So there's those two guys, and at the end, as we saw, he obviously told the Earl what he saw, and he saw Ragnar and Rollo and Floki, you know, testing out this new boat, you know, this beautiful new boat. So I think that's all the names I need to know as of this point. All right, so I think I'm gonna go one by one and talk about each character. Let's begin, Ragnar, who is clearly the lead, or, you know, the main character of this show. At least it seems that way. You never know, man. Maybe this is like Game of Thrones and like Ragnar loses his head in like episode 9 or some shit like that. But up until I see Ragnar die, it feels like he is, you know, the character, the main character of the show. Really cool character, man. Obviously, he does not quite play by the book. You know, he's got his own ideas. Doesn't like to listen to authority. That's been established. He likes to question authority. You know, and Ragnar's got these grand ideas of sailing to the west. You know, he's done going to east. You know, he's got these ideas of amazing things and cities and, you know, treasures to the west. Now let's go back to the beginning of the episode. Super cool opening. Some kind of battle's going on. Maybe I missed it, but I'm not sure if it's perhaps a battle sequence from further down the episode, not the episode, the season, or was it actually just a battle before what happened in episode one? So, like, you know, that battle happened and then it leads into it, you know, and then it unfolds into episode one. So I'm not sure if that was clear, or that, you know, I'm not really sure, but super cool to open episode one that way. Ragnar, you know, I noticed he's got this super badass look to him. You know, they've got the Viking hair, the undercut, you know, the old school undercut, but, you know, it's kind of long, it's got a ponytail and stuff. Now he's a badass, but his wife is also a badass, man. She is, like, she could take care of herself, man. She doesn't need Ragnar. So, you know, I'm liking that. I'm liking that both of them, you know, the husband and the wife are like this combo badass. Bah, super cool. You know, and they show us these two, like, creepy motherfuckers come in and, like, and she's like, come on, bro, really? And, you know, she just handles her business and, like, you know, takes these guys out. You know, so both of them, Ragnar and Gita, super cool characters. Then they have this cute little son, Bjorn, you know, and as I mentioned during the reaction, you know, I kind of felt like Bjorn. I really hope I'm saying that right. I kind of felt like him because perhaps that's how they set it up. That's how they wanted us to feel. You know, he is kind of going into this and learning all the customs and the rules. So basically, we're kind of like Bjorn, and we're picking all of this info up alongside Bjorn. And just like Bjorn, I questioned a lot of these things, man. Rolo, yeah, at first, you know, he seemed like this super cool brother. I'm not sure if he's older or younger. I'm thinking older. Yeah, you know, at first he seemed like this super cool, like, older brother, you know, I've got your back forever type thing, you know. But something happened, man. Second half of the episode, you know, he came in and Bjorn is kind of like on the shore, and then Rolo comes in. And just even at that point, something seemed off about him, man. I don't know, man. Maybe he's been talking to the Earl, or, you know, maybe I'm thinking too much. But I don't know. Something seemed off, you know, after Ragnar and Gita, you know, take care of some business. You know, they go inside, and Rolo is, you know, again asking Ragnar about this, you know, how are the plans coming along. But Ragnar has to go take a leak. And then... actually, even before that, he's, you know, he's telling Bjorn about his mother and how she used to be this fierce, like, what was it, shield? Shit, what was it called, man? It was like a position, a battle position, I believe. Shield Maiden. I think that's what it was. And he said he used to be in the same, like he was in the same front lines as her. I'm not sure what to call it, but yeah, he said, you know, basically he fought side by side. And at this point it was clear that, you know, at this point I was thinking, okay, so he clearly admires her. Now is this just that he admires her? Is this because perhaps they were lovers before she married Ragnar? It seems to be the latter, because as Ragnar goes out to take a leak, you know, he starts going off about how he had this, you know, beautiful woman. As he was, like, you know, as he was banging her, he saw her face, and then she's just, like, too bad. So now, I guess, you know, throughout the episodes, they're going to tell us what kind of past these two had, and, you know, I'm not sure if Ragnar knows about this. Maybe he knows, because, you know, it seems like customs are really loose. Not loose, but, like, everything's kind of up front, you know. Even, you know, Rolo comes up to Bjorn, fuck, I can't say his name. He comes up to the kid and he's like, you know, where's your mother and father? And he's like, oh, they're having sex. So, you know, it's really upfront. It's an intense culture for sure. Yeah, so we'll find out what's going on here. Gita and Rolo, obviously they have a past together. Maybe it's just, and it feels like it's more than just Rolo admiring her. You know, it seems like there was something more than that. So, you know, let's see how that plays out. Another character, Floki. I really like Floki. He's like a cool sidekick type character. Everyone needs a sidekick, man. Let's move on to the Earl. Okay, so he comes out. Now, I still have to, I'm pretty sure it's the guy from Usual Suspects. You know what? I'm going to look it up right now. Usual Suspects, Gabriel. Okay, Gabriel. Yeah, this is him. This has got to be him. Filmography. Ah, it is him. Earl Haraldson. Aha, it is him. Earl Haraldson. All right, so it is him. Okay. So, okay, enough of that. Of course, he ends up being the scummy leader, the group type, you know, character. Not liking him, you know, one episode in, already don't like him. He's a dick. He's out, you know, he's up to no good. The moment that one guy who got his head chopped off mentions that, oh, you knew about this land, you know, he shuts him up right away, you know, right away he cuts him off. You could tell something's going on. This guy is a bit shady, sketchy character. His wife is nice. I mean, she was nice, you know, nothing wrong with her. But yeah, and later, our boy Ragnar, you know, even tells his son that, you know, it's known that the Earl's had his eyes on his land. And just like any other scumbag chief, he's got these rats, you know, these little rats, that worked for him. You know, the first one was this, the short stubby fella, you know, he's got a beard, funny manner of speaking, and can't remember his name, but yeah, so that's one. And then the other guy is more of like a, you know, like a silent deadly type from what I've seen so far. You know, Scar, obviously he's been around, and you know, again, the final shot was him and the Earl, basically. You know, he looks at the ship or the boat, you know, I'm not sure what exactly to call it at this point. He sees it, you know, he sees Ragnar, Rolo, and Floki in there. Then he goes and tells the Earl, and I'm guessing in episode 2, the Earl's going to summon Ragnar again, you know, and this time Rolo and Floki as well, perhaps. So we'll see where that goes. Obviously, the Earl's not going to, you know, he's not really going to be too happy about this, because that's kind of like a sign of rebellion that, you know, the Earl has decided that they're going to go east again. But, you know, this guy is obviously not going to listen to that, even after he was told one-on-one, you know, to not ever, you know, go against me almost. So, yeah, man, excited. One more character, the Ancient One. A little bit creepy, but obviously he is like this respected, you know, sorcerer? I mean, I don't know. I don't know what to call him. But yeah, he's like this old school, ancient one. Of course, he's old school, you know. So I'm guessing he's going to have a bit more of a role to play in terms of, you know, this foreshadowing and... I know I keep going off on tangents, but yeah, so Ancient One, you know, we'll see how that goes. But that brings me back to the beginning of the episode, and I think one more time, or three, was it three times total they showed this? So Ragnar called him Odin. So he sees him at least twice, once in the beginning, and once before he goes back into his house. So yeah, man, Ragnar is having these visions, or, you know, is he hallucinating? Does he have some kind of foresight? I don't know, man. It's cool. I want to see where this goes. But yeah, man, in terms of characters, cool characters. I like it. In terms of technically, the locations are gorgeous, man. They've picked out some beautiful locations. You know, I'm going to look into where exactly, you know, a lot of these scenes were shot. You know, costume design is fantastic. You know, it seems like a lot of money was pumped into this by the History Channel. Oh, and one more thing I noticed. Now, I'm almost like 100% sure that this was done in post. Ragnar's eyes, his blue eyes, that's definitely pumped up in post, I think. The emphasis on his, you know, super blue, like, piercing eyes, I feel like that was done in post and color grading. All right, man, I'm digging it. First episode was cool, man. It did a really good job of introducing a bunch of new characters, and not too many, like a handful of, you know, cool characters. And, you know, I was able to keep track of all of them. They did a good job of explaining, you know, the culture and, like, the customs of the place, the hierarchy of this community. All right, man. So let me know what you guys thought, man. A lot of you guys have been recommending this. A lot of you guys wanted me to check this out, and I've been wanting to do this for a long time. Finally got the chance to do it, so... yeah, man, leave your comments, smash that thumbs up if you enjoyed it. I'm on social media for anyone new who just joined me. I'm on Twitter, on Instagram, I have a Patreon account, so everything's in the description. But yeah, man, thank you so much for checking this out. In terms of this show, like, I have like 4 seasons, I believe, to catch up to, so I feel like I can do 1 episode a day. I really feel like I can at least... do 1 episode a day, so, you know, it shouldn't take too long for me to catch up. But yeah, you know, this should be fun. 4 seasons of this, I'm really looking forward to it. But yeah, man, thank you so much for checking this out. Take it easy.